Hey, what's up? Mark here from the Backpacking Gear Nut, and today we're going to review the Sea to Summit Frontier frying pan. Full disclosure, Sea to Summit provided this pan to me for free to do an independent review of their product. I was not paid to make this video. Sea to Summit has no say over this video and will not get a chance to see it in advance. All of the opinions in this video are solely mine. So for tonight's dinner, we're gonna have steak and potatoes. And my dog Cash and I, where'd you go, Crash? My dog Cash and I are gonna have that and share it. And it's a little bit earlier because it's only 4 o'clock. So it's a little bit earlier than I would normally eat dinner, but this was frozen this morning and it's still nice and cold, but it's not frozen anymore. So I figure I'll just eat a little bit early and well, that's it. I'll eat a little bit early. So let me get this all, I'm gonna get this cut up and then I'm gonna start cooking. All right, so there you go. I cut the potatoes up in smaller pieces so it'll cook easier in the pan. And I used my little Swiss Army knife, which honestly works good, but I'm looking forward to maybe getting a few pieces of backpacking gear that are better, like maybe a nicer knife for cooking fresh food. And maybe a cutting board too, one of those little cutting boards. So now I'm gonna season the vegetables and the steak and I'm gonna start cooking. All right, so I brought some little salt and pepper packets and also some garlic that I'm gonna put on it. Okay, here we go. Here's some pepper, so a little bit of garlic. Now I'm gonna season my steak. Get some salt and pepper on there. All right, do the other side. I brought my BRS, which will work just fine, except for the platform's not super big. So I'll probably have to really watch it the whole time so it doesn't fall off. But I'm not really worried about it because I know it'll be okay. Right, now I want to get my pan going so that I can create that sear. FYI, I forgot to bring my clip for my phone for the tripod. So that's why I'm having to try to do it this way and handhold it. But let me see if I can prop the camera up somewhere. This thing's so nice. I've actually been using it at home and I tend to overuse everything that I'm gonna do a review on so that I can really make sure that it works well. There we go. Get that steak going. And get these potatoes in here too. Because the steak will actually help add some flavor to the potatoes. So it looks like it's about done. Just gonna kind of let it rest on here. The flame's out, but I'm just gonna let it rest for a few minutes. All right, so there's my meal. I only lost 2 potatoes while I was cooking, but I'm sure Cash will eat those. But the way I'm gonna cut this so I don't cut the pan itself is I'm gonna just simply take and go like this. If I get that cutting board, that'll make a big difference. That way I don't have to work so hard.
That's good.
There you go, buddy. Carrying a frying pan isn't for everybody, but for shorter hikes where I'm going to be spending more time camping and relaxing, I like being able to cook some fresh food. It's just part of the experience for me. And this frying pan weighs 13 ounces. Well, yeah, that's heavy for a pot, but not for a frying pan. This is an ultralight frying pan. It is made of hard anodized aluminum. And the neat thing is it also has this little handle right here that you can turn in like this, which I really like. The nonstick surface here is a ceramic coating. And I'll tell you what, I've never had a nonstick pan that is nonstick as this is. In the video, you saw me cook a steak in there, and that should have been pretty hard to clean up, but I was able to wipe it out and then just put a little bit of water in there and wipe it out again, and it was done. It's a fantastic pan. I've been using it like crazy at home because I wanted to make sure that this was a good item. I do things like that in order to be able to get more time with a product so that I can give you a much better review. I have not scratched it up. Of course, I am taking care of my nonstick surface where I'm not using any metal tools or anything. And it's still going strong. I actually use it at home all the time now to cook things like breakfast and stuff like that because I love this surface in here. This pan is the Sea to Summit Frontier 8-inch nonstick frying pan. There's links below, and please hit that like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.